Hey guys, welcome to my legal classes. This is Ganesh Pujari and today let us try understand the meaning and major sources of administrative law. I'll start the class with definition and then I'll give the meaning in simple words and then let us move to the major sources along with few case laws here and there. Let us start the class with definitions of administrative law. I have brought few important definitions as far as administrative law is concerned, and if you want to by heart, please take screenshot. I'll just brief you in nutshell. The first definition that I have brought from Jennings, who says it determines the organization, powers and duties of administrative authorities. So what does administrative law do? It defines the organization, powers and duties of administrative authorities. Whereas Dicey says it determines the legal status and liabilities of the state officials and defines the rights and liabilities of the individuals as far as dealing with state officials are concerned or public officials are concerned. That is all about the definition of Dicey about administrative law. Whereas Austin says administrative law is the law which determines the ends and modes to which the sovereign power shall be exercised. I think I missed one important definition, that is from Wade, who says it is all about operation and control of the public authority. So he discusses two important aspects. One, the operation. Second one, the control. So you can mention Wade's name also. I just missed it in the presentation. So these are the few important definitions. I hope you must be having some clarity now. With that, I'm taking you to meaning to bring it more clarity on the subject matter. Now that you have sufficient definitions, however, if you are not yet clarified, remember this. Indian Constitution has three major parts: legislature, executive and judiciary. Legislature makes all the laws and judiciary reviews whenever required. Now, who is actually functioning? That is executive. So whatever that is governing the organization, procedure, powers and duties of the executive can be considered as administrative laws, and these laws will consider rulemaking, adjudication or the enforcement of any public regulatory agenda. All this will come in administrative law, and these are also called as public laws. Now with that, I am taking you guys to the sources of administrative laws. The interesting question is, where are these administrative laws are formulating, or the sources for administrative laws? I have brought seven important sources as far as Indian context is concerned, and let us discuss one by one. First one being Constitution. Remember that Indian Constitution doesn't speak rigidly on separation of powers. Yes, the concept is available, but it is not too rigid. And while defining the term law under Article 13, it also says order, bylaws, notifications, all those stuffs are coming there, and most of them are done by administrative authorities or executive authorities. So they formulate administrative law. So you can consider the Constitution as the primary source for administrative laws. Then we have legislation, acts or statutes. They are also the sources of administrative laws. And we have delegated legislations. Important aspect is delegated legislations, and I have series of videos in my playlist administrative laws on delegated legislations. Please watch them because they are very important to answer those questions, as well as you have to brief them here also. Now the fourth one is judicial decisions, case laws or precedents are also the sources of administrative laws. And fifth one, ordinance by the president or governor are also the sources of administrative laws. Remember, ordinance by president is given by article number 123 and governor as per article number 213. I have mentioned them. You can take the screenshot. And the sixth one is reports by various committees. There also I have given example. Please take the screenshot and read them. And the last one, administrative quasi-legislations like the junior authority or subordinate authority following the senior authority are also formulating few laws which are called quasi-legislation. Now all these are considered as the sources of administrative laws. With that, I am concluding this session, and if you want to watch any more videos on administrative laws, please go to my playlist administrative laws, where you will get videos on delegated legislations, principle of natural justice, doctrine of ultra vires, rule of law, writs, and you name it, I have it. More than 15 videos are already available there, and I'm loading further videos on scope, nature, and many other aspects of administrative laws. Thank you so much for watching me. Please subscribe my channel. Please like, share, and comment my videos. Please press the bell icon for my future videos. All the very best for your exams, and thank you so much for watching me.